Welcome back to Investing with Confidence. As always, I am your host, Joshua David, and we are talking about the do's and the don'ts of the financial markets, taking advantage of this great opportunity, this great volatility we're seeing in these markets, especially that stock market. An online trading academy, the sponsor of Investing with Confidence, on their 25th year, teaching people just like you skills and techniques to use the market for your income accounts or your retirement accounts, whether that's 401ks, IRAs, or regular trading accounts. If you happen to miss two tickets for that investing class right here in Bloomington, we do these during the week. Also on the weekend, just call 952-814-4410 or text the word invest to the number 484848. When you do that, you'll get a text right back. There'll be a link in there to register for this free class. Pick a date, and you'll receive a financial quick start kit just for getting set up. Al, we were talking about in that last segment about, first off, understanding who moves the markets, which is the institutions, the banks, the big money, the Buffetts of the world, right? And how do we bridge that gap to trade like them? Most investors get in the market with no education, no skills, no knowledge, and just buy stocks. Well, that's been rewarded by bad behavior in the markets, which is actually a good thing for people, but in the long term, it's a bad thing. So let's talk about some of these great opportunities with this big volatility we're seeing, good moves in the markets up and down. And we talked about in the last segment as well about these New Year's resolutions coming up. How can people plan now for those New Year's resolutions to have a plan to create, have a potential to create income after hours?
Well, the word there that's important is plan. You need to have a plan, and that plan should include your goals, because you really can't determine or decide how to trade properly or invest properly unless you know what you're investing for. So it starts with having those goals. And if you're going to be in any kind of a financial situation, any kind of an investment, whether it's real estate or in the financial markets, the stock market, the Forex market, futures market, options market, your goal, if you put a position together, is to have a profit realized. And if you're buying, it means that the price has to go up to provide that profit. If you're selling, it needs to go down. And the markets don't go up all the time. They go up and they go down. So a proper strategy should result in you really not being concerned about which direction the market's going to go, because you know strategies to participate in all different directions.
So let's kind of talk about that for a second. So everybody knows a long position when markets go up.
Sure.
There's opportunities. Everybody knows that. So let's talk about this down market. When we have markets that are going down, which we see opportunities every single day, what is that concept called?
Well, shorting is one of those concepts. There are a number of different ways you can participate if the market is going down. And by the way, the money you make when the market's going down is the same green money that you make when it's going up. It $1 that you make in a down market buys exactly the same thing as a dollar you make in an up market. So how do you do that? Well, shorting is one way, which is just the opposite of what you normally do. In a typical investment situation, somebody buys, hopefully at a low price, with the goal of selling at a higher price. So you open a trade at a low price, close a trade at a high price. With shorting, you do exactly the opposite. You're selling something first. You're selling to open a position, hoping to buy it back at a lower price. It's a concept that is hard for a lot of people to understand because it seems like it's illegal. Mm-hmm. It just seems too good to be true. But we go into detail on that in these classes.
Yeah, remember, it's just a different concept, and that's what it's all about, is understanding what these concepts are. But you mentioned, you know, you actually talk about that in these investing classes.
Sure.
So hopefully we're at least informing you what's possible out there. Great opportunities, but don't miss out on them.
Yeah, well, you know, ask yourself this. Excuse me, how many times have you been talked to by a financial advisor about that downside market? Have you been talked to about shorting? There are other ways. You can use options to participate in a down market. There are what we call inverse ETFs or inverse exchange-traded funds, which go the opposite direction of the underlying. You can use futures and Forex and in down markets. So the number of different things that you just haven't been exposed to, those are the things that we teach our students. So once you understand how the markets function, what moves price, and how you can participate in all different directions, it really increases that level of confidence that you have. And all of these things, by the way, whether you are investing on the long side or the short side, you always have a risk strategy in place, because there's two things that can happen once you enter a trade. You can either make money or you can lose money. You'll never be right 100% of the time. So your goal should be, if you are wrong, to make that a small loss, which can then never become a big loss. And then also on the profit side, make sure that you are in that trade long enough to get the what the full potential profit is. To be able to do that, you have to be able to identify where sellers are going to come into that particular asset so you can have your target positioned to get out before that happens. Because when the sellers come in, it's going to start driving the price the opposite direction.
Yep. And the great thing about that is then you're not just one-dimensional. Think about if, you know, most of our listeners, if you're listening right now, you probably own a car. You actually might be driving a car right now.
Yes.
And if you have a car and it has drive that you're going forward, you also have reverse because you need to either get out of your garage, get out of your driveway, get in and out of parking spots. So you have multi-directional functions with your car. That's the same thing in the market, having multi-directional strategies, whether they're going up, whether they're going down. So that way you have the opportunity to take advantages in all market conditions. We're seeing great opportunities in the markets that you're probably missing out on. I mean, for example, you know, if the market's up, oh, who knows, we'll say 10% in 4 weeks, which it was in October, then it was down 6% in November in about 4 weeks. There's a potential of 16% opportunity. Most people probably got a couple percent out of that, mm-hmm, if they just were holding it. So there's opportunities you might be missing and being multi-directional, having more tools in your tool belt. I was actually talking to a good friend of mine in construction, and he was talking about, yeah, I have multiple tools in my belt because I need different techniques for different things. If I'm going to be cutting something, I am not going to use my hammer unless I'm having a bad day, he says. So it's just having those different tools and having opportunities, because we're seeing great volatility right, mm-hmm, now. We love this opportunity right now with markets going up and down. And it's just the public just doesn't get how to use that. And you really bring that to light. You teach these investing classes that we do right here in Bloomington at Online Trading Academy. And we've been having a lot of people come in and kind of open their eyes to what they're missing, but not missing out on it any further, because you have to start planning for that. We have New Year's resolutions coming up. I want to invite people to an investing class to take charge in their finances, take charge in their monies, is what they call it on the streets, right? So I'll call 952-814-4410 for two tickets for an investing class. This is for callers 1 through 10. When you call in right now, you're going to receive two tickets for this investing class, one for you and a friend, also a financial quick start kit. And this will actually help you get started right away. Call 952-814-4410 or just text the word invest to the number 484848. You're going to get a text back. There's going to be two links in there. One is the registrations link, so you can get in there and pick a date. We do these during the week. We also have them on the weekend, and also a little short preview on what to expect in that investing class. So you can see, hey, this is something I want to go see. What am I going to see in that? And then that way, if you have questions, bring your questions in. Al loves to answer questions in these classes. It's more conversational than just speaking in front of people, because I think you get a lot more out of that. 952-814-4410. Al, we're talking about this whole opportunity in these markets. Great volatility, great movement, let's just call it. Mm-hmm. Great movement in these markets. And there's other opportunities. You know, we talked about having multiple tools in your belt. Think of somebody having, you know, somebody has a car for their husband and their wife or their girlfriend, boyfriend, their child. They have multiple assets, we'll call it. Now, there's multiple assets in the financial markets, right, too. You have stocks, you have options, you have futures, and Forex, and cryptocurrency. Great opportunities. Mm-hmm. Some of these might be new for some people. You know, some people may know stocks, which I'm sure everybody knows about. But let's talk about those other ones for a second here. Just opportunity that people are probably missing out on, that if you're not in these markets right now, you're missing out on something big. So yeah, get into the futures market first. Explain what it is. Explain why people utilize it. And then, mm-hmm, we'll continue with these other ones.
Yeah, well, let me get back to that multiple tools thing you were talking about. The reason that carpenters have multiple tools is that they're for different objectives, different things that they're doing. The same thing is true in the markets. But here's the great thing, to keep it simple, a proper strategy, which our core strategy we believe is, helps you to find trading opportunities for income and investing opportunities for wealth by reading a price chart and showing you how to identify those. Why do I mention income and wealth as two different things? Trading for income, investing for wealth, because they're two different ways of approaching the market. If you're looking for short-term income, if you have cash needs now, you want to just kind of supplement your income from your job, maybe you want to just, you have a goal to buy a bigger house or a nicer car, whatever that is, you need money now, additional money now, not 10 or 20, 30 years in the future.
Yeah, which you need the right strategies that are designed for that type of goal that you do have.
Exactly. And you mentioned futures. Well, futures, forex, and options, those are three that you can use for short term. Unfortunately, most of you, even though you have short-term goals or needs, you're put into something that really is a long-term type of a portfolio. What is futures? Futures is probably the shortest time frame trading opportunity, probably the best thing for really short-term income needs. Basically, and it's fantastic for a number of reasons. It trades almost 24 hours a day, has huge leverage, which means that every dollar you invest or you have in a margin account can control maybe 20 to 50 to 100 times that amount. Futures has a number of different things that you can invest in, different parts of the economy. You can invest in the major stock markets. You can invest in commodities, precious metals, oil, gold, silver, currencies, interest rates, you know, your favorite.
That would be lean hogs.
Lean hogs in all the soft commodities, corn, sugar, soybeans, all
those
things. A lot
of farmers love to use the futures market to hedge their crops.
Well, they do, because when you plant a crop, you don't know for sure what the weather's going to be like, mm-hmm. what the value of that crop will be. Airlines use futures for their for fuel because that's a huge expense to them. They have to know what it's going to cost. Companies like General Mills and Cargill that deal in grains, they do future contracts. Yep. The great thing for us is that we can, as investors, also take advantage of that. And again, they're very short-term trading vehicles.
Yeah, well, us as investors, we're just speculators.
We are speculators,
you know,
exactly.
We're kind of like, think of us as the public, you know, you listening right now, a mouse. And you have a big pot of cheese, right? And you have, a big rat going for that cheese. That is the institutions. Okay. You're going to see that rat coming in there. But if you're that little mouse, that little, I think they're, what are they, pink when they're little babies?
I don't know much about mice, but I believe they are.
Let's just say that little mouse. And we're able, as a small investor, to go have the opportunity to take little pieces of that cheese because we're so small, we don't move the market. We're not going to change the trajectory of that piece of cheese. It's going to look very similar as we take little bites out of that. But when big animals take big bites out of it, you're going to see a difference, and that's going to change the appearance of that cheese. So we're a little mouse in these markets, and that's a great thing. That's what we want, because we're unnoticed in these markets. So great opportunities, especially with the futures market, trading oil, gold, silver, as Al was talking about. Another reason why I think a lot of people love the futures market is because most people invest in stocks. Right. And so because they like to say it's something tangible, it's something, they own a company. You can do that same thing in the futures market. You have oil, which is a thing.
Sure.
You have the S&P 500 you can actually trade in the futures market. The Dow Jones, the NASDAQ, the Russell. So opportunities that we're introducing to you that, you know, for those of you that are listening right now, and opportunities that you don't want to miss on because they're here and they're here to stay. We dive deeper into these topics in these investing classes that Al teaches right here on Bloomington. And these are classes where we've taught thousands, just like you, are many strategies which are designed to teach you to make better investing decisions. In these classes, we talk about how to manage risk, navigate these volatile markets, how to time the market by letting price come to you, but also our step-by-step rules-based strategy for trading any asset in any market. So I want to give away 20 tickets, and this is for callers 1 through 10 right now. You're going to receive 2 tickets when you call in. Also, a financial quick start kit, which will help you get started right away. One for you and one for a friend. All you got to do is be callers 1 through 10. The number is 952-814-4410. That's 952-814-4410. Al, coming up next, we covered futures. I want to talk a little bit more about Forex. And we talked about in the investing classes, we talk about how to time the market. Right. Let's talk about that. How to have the opportunity to time the market by letting price come to you. 952-814-4410. This is Josh and Al, Investing with Confidence. We'll be right back.